Moving along this morning, and Australia is edging even closer to becoming a cashless society. Many economists right now predicting the move may only be decades away, and this all comes as one of the country's largest banks, Macquarie, prepares to go completely cashless from tomorrow.
Yeah, to discuss this, we are joined now by Head of Research at Compare Club, Kate Brown. Good morning to you, Kate.
Good morning. Tell us, initially,
what exactly is changing for Macquarie Bank customers?
Yeah, by the end of May, Macquarie Bank will be running out all their cash. Their customers won't be able to use cash checks. They will be completely digital.
So why, wow. I mean, a few other banks are following the lead there. Why are we seeing the removal of cash and checks?
The main reason is cost. It's actually quite costly for banks to process checks, to handle cash. Cash comes with its own costs in terms of security and managing it. And we're seeing that less than 6% of Australians are using cash at point of sale now. We've seen a massive decline since COVID. It's a big cost to banks, and they're cutting it because they don't see that they're going to have a lot of customers needing it as well.
Well, I was just thinking about it the other day. The only time I really, really need cash is when you need a dollar coin to put in the supermarket trolley these days. What are the benefits of so many aspects of our lives moving cashless?
Yeah, I mean, the other one I thought of was the Tooth Fairy. That's where I was a little stuck too. Look, being cashless can be very beneficial. It can actually be a great way to manage your money. You've got a very good digital, record of everything you've spent, what you've done. You can move money. You're not losing change. You're not losing track of actual cash. But at the same time, you know, there are concerns around moving completely to the digital mode as well. There are some people that is going to affect. But for a lot of people, going cashless is just, it's quick, it's easy, it's very simple.
Well, going digital, I'm glad you highlighted that because it is going to impact so many people, like the elderly. I know my nan loves the security of having cash, you know, just cash to get by on a day-to-day basis. What are the pitfalls here?
There's quite a few. The elderly is a great example. The other one is around privacy. Cash is completely private. It's not traceable. We, you know, certainly for a lot of people who are in domestic violence situation or being financially abused, cash is the one way they can actually transact without being tracked or followed. Also for the homeless, for charities as well, charities still make a lot of money from cash donations. So there's quite a few areas where, you know, you want to have cash as an option. Another one actually is during a natural disaster. So when we've seen floods or fires, there's been a lot of people who haven't been able to purchase anything because the only option is to use cash.
That's interesting. I bet the tax man likes the idea of a cashless society too. Kate Brown, thank you so much for your time this morning.